It is now widely accepted that weed is, at the very least, less dangerous than other recreational drugs. But never forget that an excess of absolutely nothing is good, and weed addiction is a real thing. Matter of fact, I'm someone who has tried smoking weed and I've seen both the good and the bad sides of it. I can't wait to share them with you. Fun fact, I'm born at the International Marijuana Day, the 20th of April, which is actually today, the day that I'm uploading that video. So happy birthday to me. 420, baby. 420 is a cannabis culture slang for marijuana and hashish consumption, especially smoking around the time 420. It refers to April 20. Hi, my name is Atanas, your favorite health coach. And in today's video, I will talk about weed. Let's get high. No, I'm kidding. Let's get started. Is weed addiction real? Contrary to the belief of many weed smokers, it is addictive. Marijuana is one of the most widely used drugs in the world. According to the National Institute on Drug Abuse, about 9% of people who use marijuana becomes dependent on it or addicted. I will share the link down in the description. Meaning, they cannot stop using it, even if it's having negative effects on health, finances, relationships, or even their career. While weed addiction isn't associated with overdose death like other drugs, it can have serious side effects like social anxiety or laziness. At all, things that no high performer would like to experience, right? Why do we get addicted in the first place? If you're happy, organized, and having a trouble-free life, you're probably not going to want to do drugs and run the risk of addiction because you know you don't want to fuck up your life. On the flip side, if you're living in poverty, having high levels of stress and depression, living unhealthy life, or have no social mobility, you might as well be willing to start smoking pot to make yourself feel good or forget about your problems or some other made-up shit like that. You've probably heard of those studies where the rats choose some drugs over food, right? It turns out that the results are completely different if you put the rats in a rewarding social setting where there are other things to do to occupy their time. It's not unreasonable to assume that humans follow a similar path to addiction. Symptoms of weed addiction might negatively affect your decision making and motivation, can cause the loss of interest in the social and recreational activities that you once enjoyed. Next to that, you're losing interest in setting and achieving goals. The biggest sign of all is when you simply cannot stop smoking. The only way out of that is by speaking about that with a specialist or some person that you love. Together, you can find a solution for it. My experience with smoking joints. Yeah, I'm not gonna lie. Sometimes it's very funny to smoke a joint with friends and laugh at nonsense. But if you start doing it too often, for example, every month, every week, or even every day, it actually becomes far away from a funny activity. You're going to most likely find yourself sitting in a room with people who just wanna chill. Nobody wants to go for a walk, nobody wants to go meet some new people or experience something new. Nobody wants to do any other activity than walk into the kitchen and eating like there is no tomorrow. You can't do sports, you can't keep your attention on something that is not highly entertaining for more than 3 seconds. You're also becoming a contender for the World Procrastination Championship because you just wanna chill and you can do that work tomorrow. Why clean your room today when you can clean it the next week, right? Plus, you're very hungry only when you're high. The rest of the time, you're like kinda like not so hungry and you might even miss very important meals. Next to that, I realized more and more that weed is actually depressant rather than antidepressant. By the way, you not only fuck up the day with being high, but then you also fuck up the day or two after with having that weird hangover, or you can even screw up your sleep schedule. During the years, I have been in contact with many wonderful people who are unfortunately addicted to smoking weed, and I have personally seen them waste their valuable time and energy with that. And honestly, that's very sad. Currently, I'm simply asking my weed smoking friends or clients if they would like to see one day that their kids are daily high on weed. And if the answer is no, then I'm kindly asking them, then why the fuck you're doing it? After all, that's just my own opinion, and I'm not saying that it's right or wrong to smoke weed, just sharing my personal experience. Also, I'm very curious to know your story and your point of view. Feel free to share it down in the comments. At the end, I would just like to say that you're not alone in this struggle, and I'm always here to help you get through tough times. And remember, there are going to be always addictions in our lives. Try to focus on some healthy addictions and addictions that you can actually control. I am, for example, addicted to the gym and eating healthy. It's really an addiction to me and something that I cannot live without it. Do not forget to check out here my video on dopamine detox, where you can find scientifically proven methods to quit addictions. I'll see you next time with another informative video. Until then, take care and love yourself more. Bye bye.